sweet guys, change the base to the triangle airlock. As you see right here, you can actually turn these doors around to make it that triangle airlock you can shoot through. Open cell gates, which leads from our farming ship, which you'll see in a short while. And then in the center is our tool cupboard. Now I would recommend you stacking TCs, just showing you here that this is where you would probably start your starter base. For instance, as the integral part of the base is a 2x1. Up the boosted ladder hatch right here, which is to our third floor, is our furnace room, basically our cooking area. We're going to smelt all that sulfur and resources, etc. Boxes to store them in. And coming through here, the stack door, as you see as in the bottom, these boxes here, just some extra storage, which leads to our chute, as you see right there. Up to the same floor, which leads to our battlements area, which is a perfect 360 view all around the base with some unique shooting angles. Side dock shooting ports, which makes use of the soundboards, which gives you some head protection, and you can actually pop through there if you want to. And then here, these ones are just to give you some corners to peek from, to protect you from all sides of your base. And then the ladder hatch can also be used, but that's just a bit resource intensive, just put there for video purposes. Ladder hatch is right here to protect you from campers and people hugging against your wall. Coming inside the base again, up these ladder hatches right here, it leads to our loot room, which is going to be our main loot room in my opinion. You see right here these spring side gates just to show you some extra protection. All these boxes are accessible. I would store my main loot here just because I feel that it is the most protected. And here's some more extra space you can store stuff if you want to, or maybe beds can be stored there. The base is perfectly symmetrical on the other side, as you see with the loot rooms right there as well. Now this is our top floor, which makes use of these water barrels, which makes it really nice shooting ports. And some really good head protection to get a great shot. These roofs are just placed here so you can actually get down access like that and move around the base quite easily, as you see. Now these signs are all experimental. I used them in my previous build on an actual server just to test them out. I found that using these stairs you actually get quite headshot quite easily when you peek. So I thought that you could use that little gap right there to peek someone, and then you could pop out and shoot them and get the upper hand on them. Now, here on the inside, this is just some place where you can store some bolties, some extra guns, maybe meds, I don't know, whatever you store here at the top. I would recommend you build a base maybe one or two levels higher, as the loot is quite exposed from the top if they raid from the top. But just a suggestion, build some external tool cupboards and that will solve the problem, or multiple bases around your base to defend in case of an online raid. So I really hope you guys enjoy this base tour and you're going to enjoy the base build. I'm going to go through over a few things in the base layout quickly just to explain the integral parts and some key features of the base and explain why I built it. So once again, I really hope you guys enjoyed it and you stay tuned, chill it out and enjoy it. Sweet guys, you see here is the floor layout of the actual base, where you can clearly see that the integral part of the base is a 2x1, which is honeycombed on the left and right inside, so as the upper and bottom part. So the main idea behind this base is to create a base for small groups which plan on playing on hard pop for no-load servers, to actually fortify the sides of the base as much as possible so they could actually have some fun, run around and still have a secure base. Now the base is stacked in quite various ways, as you see on the left and right hand side, spaced away to create two layers extra, and then there on the top left, right, bottom and right hand side are some stacks which you use the square and the triangle. And then top and bottom side are double stacked doorways just to create that extra little space to protect that center tool cupboard, which is the most important idea of the base. In all my bases I try to beef up the base as much as possible to protect that center tool cupboard, because leaving that weak leaves your base basically useless and the raiders can just take over your base completely. So as you guys know, my bases are to be built on vanilla servers and to be quite easy to build. Some are hard, but this one I feel is quite easy and very achievable. So I hope you guys stay tuned and watch the base build. Enjoy it. Cheers. sweet guys, this is how far I'm gonna build a base. I want you guys to be creative on how you build the rest of the base. If there's any questions on the base that I built, please ask me and put it in the comment section, and I'll be glad to help you, and I'll even post a video if that's gonna help you. Thanks you all for watching so much, I really appreciate it, and please leave a like and a comment if you really liked it, or subscribe if you haven't already, and those who have already subbed, thanks a lot, I really appreciate you guys. I hope you have an awesome night or day. Enjoy your day. Cheers.